In this video, what we're going to be talking about is how to fully step into your power. Because here's the thing, is that a lot of us are not fully stepping into our power, allowing our gifts to come through, where we can fully be who we're supposed to be. Because a lot of us are so bogged down by all these future and these past thoughts, projections into the future, projections into the past, not allowing our true power to come out. Because here's the thing, is that a lot of us are unconsciously keeping our attention and our focus in the thinking mind without necessarily realizing that we're doing this to ourselves. And this is not allowing our true power to come out. Because when you're fully in your power, you're not necessarily thinking about the future. You have that vision in mind, but it's not bogged down by the anxiety and the fear and the worry. And these are all results of the ego. And when I say ego, what I'm talking about is the unconscious thought processes that we may not necessarily be aware of because we're so caught up in the thinking. And so thinking is a powerful tool that we can use, but a lot of us don't use this thinking as the tool that it's designed to be to help us fully step into our vision. But we're too caught up in the future with all the anxiety. Because here's the thing, is that when you're living in the ego, in other words, when you're living in the unconscious thought processes, you tend to live in anxiety, you tend to live in worry, you tend to live in agitation, fear. And these things are not allowing us to fully step into our power and finally do what we're supposed to be doing. Because everybody has a gift. Everybody came here to do something. But if you are not allowing those gifts to come out and fully step into your power, you are doing a disservice to humanity. Humanity needs you to step into your power. Let me say that one more time. Humanity needs you to step into your power, because when you are not in your power fully, you're doing a disservice to yourself and humanity, because you have a gift that you're supposed to leverage for yourself so that you can become abundant and also serve people in the way that you're supposed to serve them. But this is never going to happen if we're too caught up unconsciously in the thought processes. In other words, the ego. I'm telling you right now, the ego, and I'm just using this word as a symbol to represent unconsciously being in your head. I'm telling you right now, that is the number one barrier that is not going to allow you to fully step into your power. Because for me, fully stepping into my power means being in a flow state, having the masculine intention to push my message out into the world, but then also combine that with a flow state energy. It's a feminine energy of falling back and allowing. And so when you combine these two energies together, what you'll find is that you can fully get to your purpose, fully step into your power a lot quicker, and you're not going to be bogged down by all this extra unnecessary thinking. And so once again, the thinking is a useful tool, but it's not about getting rid of the thinking completely. It's about using it as the tool that it's designed to be so we can fully step into our power. Because it's not about getting rid of the thinking completely. It's about getting rid of the compulsive thinking that we involuntarily and unconsciously are doing throughout the day without realizing it. All these projections into the future, all these projections into the past, they're not serving us. And then we think that it's serving us by overanalyzing, but it's doing nothing for us a lot of the time. And so there's this beauty. There's this aliveness in the present moment that can only be accessed through experience, through accessing the present moment, but not by thinking, but by experiencing it. And when you connect it as part of yourself, you will step into your power a lot quicker. Because we all came here to do something. There's always some kind of a passion, some kind of service that we're supposed to give others, whether you're a guitar player, whether you're an artist of some kind, whether you're making videos, whatever you do, the way to step into that part of yourself is always going to be correlated with some kind of a flow state, some kind of a flow state energy. And this requires to step out of the thinking mind, because the mind is only one part of reality. It's just one part. There's also the heart. Are you living from your heart center? That is an extremely crucial part of stepping into your power fully. Following your heart center, not your thinking, because the thinking is only one part of stepping into your power. And if you're completely dominated by the thinking mind, it's not going to allow you to fully step into your power. So it's all about connecting deeper into the present moment, finding the deepness and the aliveness of the present moment that is always here right now. We just may not see it because we're too caught up in the thinking. So that's all I have for you today. If you like this kind of content, then consider hitting that subscribe button and that notification bell, because I post a video every single day. But you gotta make sure to hit that notification bell, because that's the only way to see the videos that I post every single day. If you wanna go a little bit deeper into the present moment, stop being so absorbed by all the unnecessary content and the thinking in the mind, finally fully step into your power, combine the present moment with your life purpose, consider connecting with me, because I have powerful one-on-one sessions, and you can contact me by hitting the website that is in the description box of this video. Have yourself a great day, and see you in the next video.